Welcome back to Two Steps Ahead Podcast. Two Steps Ahead Podcast, highlighting the stuff we've stepped in so you don't have to. My name is Son Edom, alongside somebody who had such an awakening last week that we decided to come back. We forced Dr. Irene to sit here and come back and deal with Tara more. So that's been so helpful.
Yeah, she gave us some couples therapy, actually, because I have to deal with him, too. Yes. Hey, guys, welcome back. I am Tara Hoke Shiro, and we are still here again with Dr. Irene.
Hi.
How are you? Yes, so after the show last week, we were talking about some of the stuff that we had talked about, and then we got into some conversation that I thought would be really good, and Dr. Irene thought it would be great. Actually, she was gracious. Actually, we kind of bribed her. But to come back here and talk to her some more. And so we are at Hillside Wellness Center. And you can find Hillside Wellness Center online at hillsidewellnesscenter.org. And if you go back to the last week's podcast, you'll find out what we talked about and some more information. But at the end of the podcast, we talked about therapy and how therapy is good. And it's not necessarily, or it shouldn't be deemed as something that's a weakness, but actually a strength. And you can go back and listen to that podcast. And so what we're going to do this week is have a little bit more fun with the conversation. And with Dr. Irene Yaymadjian. And again, you're a PsyDy. And that's a doctor of psychology.
Correct.
And you are an LMFT, a licensed marriage family therapist.
Yep. Have you been practicing all week for this?
Yes, I practiced all week. Because last week we butchered it, so we had to redo.
No, we?
Yes, we. We're in this together. And again, so you mentioned last week that you mentioned that the reason you got into psychology was because of a friend's suicide. And it's kind of sad in a way that sometimes things like that trigger something, but then the good that comes from it. Because I can only imagine the stuff that you've been doing lately with people and helping people. And I had a friend in high school that changed. He died in a car crash, and we were supposed to go to school together, college together, roommates, things like that. And it put me on a completely different road. And whether it's a good or bad road, I don't know. But sometimes events happen, and it puts us on a course. And all the good that comes from that, even though it was such a terrific event, a bad event, not terrific as in that, but terrifying, the good that can come from it. So I can only imagine the stuff that you've been doing to help people recently with all the stuff that's been going on has probably been quite incredible. And I mean, could you just imagine you not being there for some of these people, to help them? I mean, it's just the stuff that you've been doing, it's just been awesome.
Yeah, the suicide, depression, all the rates of that, and drug use, especially meth use, has been on a rise recently, especially during this whole COVID time. And so a lot of people, losing their jobs, businesses being destroyed, all these things have been really affecting them, and it's been really sad. So to help a person pick up the pieces and start over, or continue moving forward with their life, has been definitely a thing that all of us therapists have been doing. So it's an important component to everyone's life.
Now, you mentioned moving forward, and so that's one of the things that we really want to focus on, is not the past, but look into the future. What can we do? What are some of the things that we can do to get ourselves into a better position, both mentally, maybe spiritually, maybe psychologically speaking? And one of the things that I like to do is travel, get out and about. And I recently, since Vegas opened up, I've been to Vegas. I went to Vegas, and it was
I'm so jealous.
It was actually a lot of fun because there wasn't a lot of people there. They had it really pretty safe. The pool was practically empty. There was a few people there, and so we got to meet some people and talk to people, and somebody had a cabana, and they invited us into their cabana. So it was a lot of fun, and I think I inhaled so much hand sanitizer that I think my body is actually purified, and so, by osmosis, because it was everywhere. I mean, you put a quarter, let's say, in the slot machine, and then as soon as you got done, someone's there wiping it down with, Clorox and bleach and spray. So it's actually one of the safest environments that I've seen with this whole COVID thing. But then I went to Nebraska recently and got to visit some family, because Nebraska is an open state. And so we got to go out to restaurants and eat and things like that. And that feeling of just getting out and going someplace was really refreshing, because when I came back, I got depressed again, because I was back in California. But it was just refreshing to get out of the environment, because we've been locked down. We've been in the home. We've been in this situation, but to get out and to go someplace else and to experience something else, I mean, it just did wonders for the psyche and did wonders for my perspective on life and how things are going.
No, I bet. Absolutely. Can you imagine like being stuck at home and no human interaction whatsoever? You go outside. I went to my boyfriend's family's house like, what was it, like 3-4 weeks ago for the first time. And I felt so refreshed. I was like, oh my God, human interaction. I miss you guys so much. So no, absolutely. I could totally see that happening.
And just being able to, like you said, meet. I know you've got some places or at least something you have to go do this summer.
Yeah,
and,
you know, well, we had some places to go. The fair, we usually go to the Mid-State Fair. It's been canceled. My reunion, my high school reunion is this year. I think it was...
It's your 50th?
50th. I think it's like 35 or something. 40, 35 or 40. I don't know. 85, whatever the math is for that. So... That's been canceled. We can't go back for that. There are several things. And so it does something to the mind when everything on the calendar out there is taken off. It really has a kind of a depressing, state, a kind of depressing feel about it. Now, I will say that I am getting ready to go to New York City in what, 2 weeks, 3 weeks or something like that. This is not a vacation trip. This is a, I have mentioned several times before that my daughter graduated from college. She, you know, we have to go and move her back out. We haven't been able to get back there. So we have to go and retrieve some things from her apartment. So it's kind of like a necessary thing. But I'm telling you, on one hand, I'm like, I don't want to be on an airplane. But on the other hand, I am so excited to go. The thought of like going to the airport and getting on and like going somewhere, I'm really, really excited.
What's scaring you?
What's scary?
Why are you afraid?
Actually, I think New York City is probably the cleanest city in America right now. So it's not, I think the airplane is what is bothering me because they're so packed in there and you're in a tube. And so the air is, you know,
circulating
and it's the same, you know, you can get stuck on an airplane anyway. So I'm not hugely concerned about getting, I've had pneumonia 3 times. So I could theoretically, if I got COVID, get very sick. But I'm not really concerned about it as far as like, you know, dying. But I'm just not, I don't know, I'm just not crazy about, if I don't have to be, you know, in a big crowd of people, I don't, you know, I would prefer to wait a while.
Very smart.
But I am really excited about going back to the city. I think the subways are super clean right now. I think, you know, everything is going to be super clean.
See, when I recently went to Nebraska, we had to, so the trip was to visit some family, but then also I wanted to get back to my radio roots. And so Nebraska was the second state that I went to for my radio. Iowa was the first. So I got to hit Iowa and my very first radio station. And so that was another draw for me going to get back to my radio roots. And so on the flight, we had to lay over in Vegas the first time. And then we laid over in, where did we come back from? But we had a couple of layovers. I think both were Vegas. And when they left the plane, the people that left the plane, because we stayed on, they came in, they wiped everything down, they cleaned everything. So I think the fear of that is probably going to be not as bad as you think, because they're going through, they're taking so many measures to make sure people are safe. Mm-hmm. Just, yeah. And so I don't think that that's going to be too bad getting on the plane, because my experience was it was fine. And I think they told me that they pump 80% oxygen, 20% Lysol through the plane. So you're actually like inhaling.
Or inhaling, you know? Oh, Lysol.
No, I'm just kidding.
Do they make you wear masks on the plane?
Yes. So, okay, so here's the thing. Okay, yes.
How are you supposed to eat a drink?
Oh my God,
okay,
that's so unhealthy.
No,
though.
So the rule is, or so they said, that you have to wear masks, or I wore the airport was optional because I flew out of Burbank.
Okay.
So the airport was optional, but when you boarded the plane, it was mandatory. When you got on the plane, it was mandatory. But when you eat or drink,
you can take it off.
Well, I hope so.
So I made a bag of M&Ms last 2 hours.
I was just going to say, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have a drink in front of me the entire 5 hour flight.
I made a bag of M&Ms last 2 hours. So yeah. I was maskless. But then too, so there's 4 different flights technically. One flight was from Burbank to Vegas, so it was a short trip, and they really didn't pressure anybody to wear masks, and mm-hmm. most people didn't have them. They had them on, or they would take them off, you know, but it wasn't enforced. when everybody disembarked the plane in Vegas, there was only 10 people left on the plane going from Vegas to Omaha. They made everybody wear a mask, and they were kind of like zealot about it. Like if you took it off, they'd be like, no, put it back on.
Is this the same airline?
Same airline.
Just different crew.
No, same crew.
Oh, wow.
That is what was ironic, because there was less people on the plane than there was going from Burbank to Vegas, than from Vegas to Omaha, but yet they forced us on the longer flight. That's when I pulled out the bag of M&Ms. I was like, okay, we'll see.
Oh, but you can still take it off when you're
you
eating.
Can take off, yeah, you can when take it off when you eat and drink. Yeah.
You know, it's not healthy to have your mask on that long.
I didn't think so.
No, it's because you're breathing like carbon dioxide or something, right?
And you and bacteria, I mean, I'm not a medical doctor, but I mean, common sense, it's bacteria grows in, you know, moisture and all that. You need to have fresh air, I guess. You're not really getting fresh air on the plane.
No, but
right?
But it was just something weird about it, because and then the other flight attendants on the different flights, some of them didn't even care. Some of them were in the back yucking it up because there's no services anymore.
Yeah.
So there's no like beverages. There's at least when I was
but
on
then
it.
Oh, the wait, power the, trips.
Yeah.
Not even on the long trip, there was no beverage service anything.
No, they gave you like a can of water, like water in a can. Yeah, water in a can.
Oh wow.
Yeah, they gave like instead of a can of soda, they gave you like water in a can.
How did that taste?
Tastes like tin. And then I asked them, I said, okay, because I learned. So on the flight back, I'm like, can we get ice? And of course, the flight attendant was like, oh yeah, if you want ice, you can get ice. So I thought on the way back, you know, I stacked up my carry-on with like, you know, a liquor cabinet. But then they didn't give me any ice.
Should we talk?
What's that?
Do we need to talk?
I think so.
Therapy.
I think so. No, but I had beverages. They weren't adult beverages. There was a Monster energy drink, which I like. And then I threw a can of soda in there as well, just as backup. Because, you know, you never know when you're going to be stuck on a plane
I'm
for so hours.
I'm so glad that you said that, because on a 5-hour flight, I'm thinking if they're not giving services, then
well, this
I'm
was a certain airline,
drink.
Which I will refrain from. I'll tell you afterwards. Okay. Don't you hate that when people say something? Southwest.
Okay, I'm flying a different airline, okay. So I will bring back the experience from the other airline.
And it wasn't bad. Like I said, it was fine, but that's just what they did. And so some of the flight attendants were like, they didn't care because they were yucking up in the back without their masks on. But like I said, it didn't matter to me because I made a bag of M&Ms last 2.5 hours. And then they did bring on one of them, they brought their little snacky things. Which was like a bar mix of like pretzels and peanuts and some other, you know, Rice Krispies or whatever. And so I had that as backup just in case my M&Ms ran
You're just
out.
Like eating
and then I just
the
started
whole
eating.
Time.
Yeah. Maybe that's why this I gained 20 pounds on the trip was the air flight. But the whole idea of just getting out.
Yes.
Regardless, was made it exciting. And I'm hoping to get a couple places more later this summer. Maybe go back to Vegas. I don't know. I did want to go to South Beach. But I don't think that's going to happen. Someone recommended Puerto Rico because they went and stayed at an Airbnb in Puerto Rico, and they had a great time. But
are they doing like masks and stuff as well?
Yeah. See, I didn't get that full story from them because they kind of disappeared. Maybe they're in quarantine. I don't know. Well, they were through social
what
media.
Does that mean?
Well, it's through social media, and so texting and stuff, you know, so it wasn't like face-to-face talking. And so they were telling me about Airbnb in Puerto Rico. That was really good. I'm like, oh, that might be cool to go see. And then we were kind of, hey, what'd you do? And they were kind of describing, you know, just kind of being out on the beach, eating. And then all of a sudden, you know, they stopped communicating. So I hope they're okay.
Maybe you should reach out to them.
I don't know. Maybe I should.
I was trying to go to Hawaii. I was looking up Hawaii and it was all booked.
Was it really?
Everything is booked. Everything, there's nothing available.
You mean like hotel, airline?
I was like, wow. What on earth? Some of the airlines had a few trips still there, but Hawaii is fully booked. But then when you think about it, it's not fair to go there. Don't your symptoms start after 2 weeks?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And it's funny that you say Hawaii, because I just asked my husband the other day, I said, is there even COVID in Hawaii? Like, I haven't heard it on the
like
news that they've.
Low.
Well, see, someone I knew went over there. And they didn't realize it, but when they landed, this was probably a month ago, they stuck them in a 2-week quarantine, and they couldn't leave the hotel.
Yeah, you're supposed
to Hawaii?
Go.
Yeah.
Yeah, anywhere you go now, like, you have to be in a 2-week quarantine, and then you can come out. Yep. Like, you can't just go and, like, do your stuff. And well, so, sure you can go to New York?
I was going to say, wait a second. You mean, are you talking?
It might be out of.
Well, no, I'm talking, I don't know, but Hawaii specific in this case.
Yeah.
They went from here to Hawaii. And when they landed in Hawaii, they were put in a 2-week quarantine.
You have to go do 2-week quarantine and then you can go out and do
things. What if your vacation's only a week?
That's like that. Too bad. Yeah. Because they got out, they were like, screw this, mm-hmm. I'm going. And they went out on the beach and the police actually came and they said, oh, we're tourists. And they said, oh, you have to be quarantined. Like, oh, we didn't know. And that's how they got away. But locals or other people, you know, you have actually gotten arrested for violating the quarantine. Wow. Maybe that's why there's no quarantine.
So maybe, New York, yeah. You need to do two hours.
2 hours quarantine.
No problem.
2 weeks of quarantine.
I don't. But I was thinking that maybe I might have to do it when we come back. But now New York has the lowest rates in the country, and I think it's the most sanitized besides Vegas. So I'm not sure, but I haven't heard.
Check with them because I was looking in Hawaii and everything was booked, which was very weird because there's quarantine. But I don't know. It's
so if you go, then that means you would have to be there for 3 weeks if you want a week vacation and
pay for
they,
3 weeks, but only have a week.
What does that?
That doesn't even make
that
sense.
That doesn't make sense. Where are they keeping people for 2 weeks?
What's this 2 week thing? Like I don't. Okay, I don't, well, we're going on a different route now.
Well,
but
it's I guess it's the.
Well, it's the 2 week incubation period.
The incubation, yes.
So then after that, you have your symptoms and then you go out?
No, it takes 2 weeks.
Or you have no symptoms and then you go out. Yeah.
Right, yeah.
You know? Either way.
Because it takes 2 weeks, I guess, for the symptoms to show up once you're infected. So if you.
Huh. Yeah. Make sure you know about New York because I know places that. I know England's close.
Yeah, I should ask. Yeah, I definitely should. I mean, the hotel didn't say anything when I booked the hotel.
It's online.
The airline didn't say anything,
but they're probably you're good.
Yeah, I should probably Google it.
But see, all this adds to, we talked about a little bit about last week, just the stress of life with everything going on. Mm-hmm. All this kind of adds to it because you're thinking, oh, Hawaii, you know, hey, that's going to be great. Oh, wait, now what are the regulations? Mm-hmm. Or you got to go to New York. I know New York is more of a business type trip, you know, instead of like vacation because you got to, you know, take the, you know, apartment, about you know, pack up.
So, pack up the apartment.
So it's the there's a purpose besides just going and vacationing.
Right.
But that kind of adds to it. And so with that in mind, getting away though, besides the places that we, cause the family reunion was, I didn't have to go. It's not like I have to, but you know, it's one of those things you take advantage of, you know, it's like, okay, the family wants to get together. Okay. I'm going to make it happen. Vegas was just a free thing. It was like, I'm going to go because I want to be there on opening night. Mm-hmm. And the Vegas strip was like empty.
It's FOMO.
But so if there was a place to go, like you mentioned Hawaii, but if there was a place to go, where would you want to go? Cause I want to go to Fiji.
Fiji.
I don't want to go to Fiji.
Wow.
Go hang on the beaches of Fiji.
Hang on the beach for a week and...
Yes, and drink fruity cocktails, drinks with umbrellas.
Fruity drinks with umbrellas. Yes.
Drink with umbrellas.
That's my dream. And I want to raise my hand so the waiter comes by.
Maybe do some parasailing.
You can get the same experience kind of in like Mexico.
Oh, can you?
Like less...
Really?
Or even in Oxnard.
Yeah.
They have at the Mandalay, they have, you know, fruity drinks with umbrellas.
Or Palm Springs. We're just like ruining it for
exactly.
Yeah, thank you. You're supposed to help me feel better, not worse about myself.
All the way over there for an umbrella drink.
I want to go to Fiji so I can drink Fiji water in Fiji. That's the only reason.
With an umbrella.
Yes. Does Fiji water come from Fiji?
I don't know. That's a good question. I don't know.
Probably.
But I want to raise my hand and have someone bring me Fiji water. From Fiji.
You know what?
And hang out with the Fiji mermaid.
And you want to know what is so this is so like beyond like foo-foo. So I went on this business trip with my husband. I don't even remember where it was now, but they had a pool and it was like a resort. And so the first day I went down to the pool, he's in his business meetings and I go down and lay by the pool and I ordered a tuna salad sandwich or so, I don't remember what it was. The next day I come down to the pool. The guy knows my name. Hi, Mrs. Shiro. Would you like your da da da? He repeats my entire order, and and I'm like, oh, this is really nice.
Wow. Right?
You just have to show up, and they're like, hey, you know, here's your food, here's your drink, here's your fries.
Go to them, remembering your name,
right? I was so impressed. I'm
but
like,
you're also
even...
so pretty. So she was like, oh, I'm gonna remember her.
I'm like, okay, I don't even have to do anything. Just show up. They know that. They like the wives are there, you know, with the.
I guess what we're talking about is really the feeling of
pampering.
Yes, that's what we miss. I have a Burke Williams membership and I probably have like 25 massages right now. I can't wait until you can like go and just get pampered, you know?
Yes.
Because how many of us right now would love to kind of have a drink or just lay on the beach, not worry about this and not worry about that. And or get a massage, you know, or go to a spa, like all that stuff that was very normal.
Well, it was funny. We talked last week a little bit about social media, but one of the things I like about social media is you kind of get a little bit of the taste of what's going on in society, mm-hmm. a little bit of a pulse of society, because you had the point where you talk about pampering, you know, people were talking about their hair, people were talking about their nails, people were talking about, you know, what they look like coming out of the lockdown into the summer, you know, and like you had memes flying that probably would be like, now guys are going to look at people's women's intellect instead of their bodies because they're going to be out of shape.
God,
you
know? I don't think that's ever going
to
happen.
So there's all this stuff. But anyways, but the point was, is that you started to get this kind of sense of like, I need to get my hair done. I need to get pampered. And then when things started to open up, or the underground started to open up with the underground salons, people started to feel better, and the whole kind of theme of the social media changed to something like, okay, now we're focusing on other things and not the negative, but now we're focusing on these positive things because they all did just get pampered.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
The grays are no longer there, or the nails aren't chipped, or yeah. whatever, and it makes you feel good.
Yeah, no, I think that's such an important thing. And also, I mean, I guess this is what we're kind of going at today is, you know, doing things that make you feel good, and traveling is one of them. So going places, whether it's your nail salon or Fiji.
Yes.
Or the nail salon in Fiji.
Oh. With the Fiji mermaid.
With yes. a little fish in the water. Yes. Oh,
do you ever do that?
No, I've always wanted. I've never really. Have I been anywhere tropical? Oh, I've been to Mexico.
Yeah.
Oh, Hawaii. I've been to Hawaii. What am I talking about? Have I been to somewhere tropical? But nowhere like Fiji or like Maldives. Is it Maldives? Is that how you pronounce
Maldives.
It? Yeah, Maldives. I love the Maldives.
Really?
Yeah, I would love to go there.
I've seen pictures and it's beautiful.
Oh my God, yeah.
Beautiful.
And there's a place, I think it's where it's like the Black Sea and the other sea they meet. It's like in India. I can't remember where it is, but there's pictures of it. That's where I would love to go. You can actually walk on the water because the two oceans meet together.
Oh, that'd be
have
cool.
you seen that?
Mm. Oh. No. No, I have not seen those pictures, but pictures are very.
I'll show you.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I would love to. Just like go out, yep. go somewhere else and meet different people and talk to them and just like open your mind, because I feel like even if it is Fiji, you know, just kind of relaxing. Would you actually be able to relax?
In Fiji?
Yeah.
What do you mean? Absolutely.
Like if you went right now.
Oh, yeah.
You would have to do two hours of. Why do I keep saying two hours?
I don't know if Fiji has a quarantine.
Okay, so if they
but
don't.
But if they don't, I would definitely just be able to relax.
You would be able to relax? Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So it was like Vegas. Part of the problem with Vegas was a lot of people weren't there because there was a fear.
Yeah.
And I just don't have that fear. I don't have that fear of that. So that doesn't hinder me from. So I was at the pool. I don't gamble a lot. I don't go to Vegas to gamble a lot. But the pool and some of the other amenities and the trip this time around. Usually I will schedule a Vegas trip around a sporting event that's going on, so that I have something other than the gaming. But because it was just opening night, I want to go for opening night.
The gaming?
There.
Is
the
that gaming. What we call it
yes,
now?
The yes, gaming. The gaming. It's the gaming.
The gaming. Instead the gaming.
The gaming.
Working the arm.
The hand, yeah, my workout. And my right arm is stronger
or
than
like
my left
passing
arm.
Passing up cards.
But I didn't have any fear because I was able to enjoy it, to get back to your question, because I didn't have a fear of anything.
Yeah. No, that's, yeah, I mean, when you said the pool was empty, I was like, oh.
Yes.
Yeah, that sounds really nice. Yeah. And to be fair, like, I don't, like, going to New York or going someplace else, it's not that I have a fear of being in crowds right now. I looked it up, actually. So at this point in history, 9 million people worldwide have gotten the COVID. Approximately 500,000 people have died from the COVID. So I did the math on Google, and that's about 5%-ish.
So
5%. So it's not a super high death rate. In the United States, I think we're somewhere around 2 million and somewhere around 100,000 deaths, I think. So it's not that I'm like in fear of going out, but I also am concerned about other people, and I don't want to. I kind of feel like I to lay low just to help protect, you know.
But how long are we going to? That's the important thing. Like, you know how I said I went to like spend time with family. It was just such a breath of fresh air. So
yes.
What would make you actually feel safe if you went there? Like, what would you do to make you feel safe? Because you can't really protect other people. Right.
Well, I think that we can be responsible. I think there are people that are getting sick. There are businesses that are shutting down because employees are sick. I think there are people that are dying. There are people that are on ventilators.
Absolutely.
And so I just feel to be responsible, I feel like I should not be reckless in going. So it's not like I don't completely, you know, stay home. Obviously, we're going to New York, you know, and our 25th, not our 25th, but my husband and I's 25th anniversary is coming up. And so we would like to go somewhere for that. We're trying to figure that out. But I guess being like, oh, I'm just going to go wherever and not worry about anything. I personally don't feel that that is responsible either. So I guess this is just kind of like dreaming about when we can move about the planet, you know, in a way that's not so restrictive and, you know, where would we go? And that freedom actually is going to be really nice. Yeah. To think about, like, I can just go with no restrictions and it's going to be great and enjoy and partake. And so I don't know. I feel like a social responsibility, I guess, not to be just to go out willy-nilly. And, you know, I feel like I should do my part to not help because I could be spreading it to somebody. I could be a carrier and spread it to somebody without even knowing. But I don't walk around with like a fear. I just think that we are in a mess right now. And I just like to be responsible to my fellow.
And yourself.
Human beings.
Most importantly to yourself.
Yeah.
And then when you protect yourself, you protect other people too.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
I wonder when the time is going to come though, when we can just like travel, because that's one of the reasons why I'm not going anywhere, because I just can't stand to think like, I don't want to go somewhere and then have to quarantine and have to do all this stuff. So I'm just going to stay here until everything is open. I'm just going to take a huge vacation when everything is open.
Mm-hmm. And where are you going to go
next year? Where do I want to go? Well, yeah, it'd be was it Maldives?
The Maldives, uh-huh.
Yes. I would love to go there. And another place, of course, Hawaii. I always want to go to Hawaii. I love Hawaii.
Hawaii, I've been to Maui. It is absolutely amazing. And I actually saw some pictures of a hotel in Greece. Mm-hmm. Oh, that was just
like Santorini and, or which?
It might have been Santorini. It might have been Mykonos. Mykonos.
It's so pretty.
I can't remember which. Yeah. It's gorgeous. And yeah. And this Instagram. So I was looking at like somehow, you know how you follow a rabbit trail sometimes on Instagram and you come across this most amazing, like, wow. Mm-hmm. And the pictures were all about the hotel in Greece, and they were the same type of pictures, just different people had posted, different guests over the years had posted them, but they was basically the same, hundreds and hundreds of different angles of this, but it's a hotel that's in the rocks on the cliffs overlooking the ocean. And so the hotel is, there's like on an upper part, and then you go down a level in the rocks, and there's a bunch of rooms there, and then you go down in the rocks, and there's a bunch of rooms there, and there's pools everywhere on all these different levels, and you can swim up, like there's these swim up bars, there's like a the endless pool where you look out and it just drops off. What do you call, like the endless pool?
Oh my God.
It looks like it goes into the ocean. And all the pictures were basically the same, but I could not, there were hundreds of them and I couldn't stop scrolling through this feed and looking at every, because they were so, so gorgeous. And there was pools inside the rooms. And there were, you know, it was crazy.
Greece is really pretty. I have had a few friends go and they've always said it's so, so pretty. Another place, Thailand. I've been wanting to go to Thailand. I was supposed to go to Thailand last year. I don't know what happened, but Thailand,
I've
definitely
heard.
Like, yeah. That's one place I would love to go. It's just so beautiful and the water's so pretty. I want to go play with the elephants.
Yes.
You know, like just like, I love elephants. At our center, we have various pictures of elephants. And so it's just, yeah, I think, I mean, just doing this, especially during a time like this, like you said, stepping out of your bubble. I think once we're able to travel, we'll be able to kind of like fall back into our normal and we'll stop being so terrified.
Right.
Because to be quite honest, there's so many things in the air. There's so much bacteria. There's so many different viruses that we don't even know about. And we just walk right through it at times, not even knowing that. I hope one day it's just going to get there, which it will, where we could just live, you know, and, but yeah, I don't know. It's nice to go somewhere and just relax. And if you can do that at Fiji, you better post pictures.
Well, I could do that. Yeah. I would definitely
live through
do that
some,
if I get
it's
there.
Like, oh, yes. He's at Fiji.
Yes.
I don't know. I just have the ability, I guess, not to worry about that type of thing and just kind of enjoy. And you'll know, like Tara's always mentioned, kind of the fact that something happens, I just kind of, okay, this happened, let's just move forward. Or this happens, you know, I don't really dwell on
good
something.
Good way of looking things.
And so that's just it with the way life has been right now. I've taken it and been like, okay, how can I continue to just kind of move forward in life my way so that I can just be me, you know? And that's, like I said, either earlier going to the beach or maybe getting out to Vegas when it opens, or to go and visit family in a place where it's open. You know, cause the cases in Nebraska were like very minimal. I mean, mm-hmm. there's like no risk there. Mm-hmm. And so there was, you know, places like that. And then the other thing too, is it's just like you said, if you've been kind of locked down, you know, everybody gets, antsy, you know, you get, I don't know what the term is, but you know, you're in a place, you get kind of like claustrophobic, you want to get out, you know? Mm-hmm. And so.
It's lonely too.
And that too, exactly.
You know, just having human interaction, the energy you share with someone. And if you go to a different, you know, place, you get to learn about their culture and opens your mind up.
In fact, and when I went to Vegas, I saw a guy who I used to coach baseball years ago, and he was in Vegas by himself. And he just wanted to get away. Like you said, just wanted to get away because he was tired of being by himself. And his friends were a little bit more concerned about everything. So they were more cautious and want to get out. And he's like, I'm done. I'm going. And he just went on his own. And then we happened to run into each other at the roulette table. Don't play roulette unless
they
you
were
really
gaming.
Don't. Yes, well, we're gaming. Gaming and drinking. Two bad vices to do at the same time. Money goes quicker when you drink and game. No, but there was just that mentality of getting out and just doing nothing. But talk about pampering. Okay. You talk about pampering. This was pampering for me. Sitting by the pool, had the umbrella over it. They bring you a bucket of beer. So you have like five beers.
That is your
big
kind
thing of
pampering.
Ice cream, like
did
a
you do a review by the pool?
No, I should have though. I should have. But see, I was so wrapped up in the moment of
like,
just relaxing.
Hallelujah, chorus.
Yes, and
that
just
was an
like
awesome
being there.
Review.
So when I go back, I will do that.
Yeah,
when,
go back go and back like sit by the pool and be like, this is my bucket of
you
beer.
Were so taken aback by your, by the joy that you
and it was funny because, yes, it was. And I was just, sitting there. And someone came up to me as some stranger and they looked at my bucket and they're like, you're going to drink all that? And I'm like, duh.
She's like, geez, don't make me feel bad about it.
and the lady came talking about, you know, waving your hand or raising your hand, but the lady kept coming over and filling the bucket with ice. But, so that was a sense of pampering and, you know, it took me a few hours to get through it, but it was just fun because you're just sitting there.
Talk about food.
Okay. So then food.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
They were
right
able
now.
To.
Potato skins. Well, that's cool. Really good right now.
But see, that was the burgers. Beauty of the fact that the pool, for example, in this case was kind of empty and going there because you had individualized attention. There were like three or four attendants, you know, working the pool area and not enough people to really keep them busy. So they were just looking for something to do. So they kept coming back. And then they'd like, you know, bring you, you could order food and you could sit by the pool side. So it was a lot of like, you know, finger foods, you know, that we got like the French fries and
we need
the,
to go right now.
I was just going to say, why don't we just go to Vegas
strips.
Right now?
Yeah.
It's the perfect time.
Yeah, we should
it was. It was, yeah, it was. It was. It was like I said. And then stayed at New York, and they had the roller coaster.
Yes.
Rode the roller coaster. That is like
I
the best
hate that
experience.
Roller coaster.
So much fun.
It is so scary. Like,
so fun.
Because the roller coaster, you know how a normal roller coaster, you fly around the corners, but on that one, you feel like you're going to fly off because when it goes around the corner, like you look down and it's cityscape and it's cars and so it's like, and it's on the top of the building.
And
so when you fly around, it's like, woo, you're just going to fly right out.
But see, you mentioned something, I think, last week about endorphins.
Yes.
And so anyway,
when I run,
yeah. So it's that type of exhilaration that gets the mind going and gets something going where you get off of that thing and you're just like, dude, I can go home now. I think, in fact, I said that.
Yeah.
I can go home now because it was so exhilarating and it just awakened everything and it kind of like took all the rust and crud that had been collecting over the last few months and just kind of like blew it because you were just like full of just like stimulation. It was like the best thing ever.
When you play cards, you played cards, right?
Did I don't really do cards. I do my games are roulette and craps.
But you see the tables, right? Did they have the dividers?
Yeah, they had the plexiglass. Yeah, so you had plexiglass between each people, and instead of a table of six at blackjack, it was only three. And on craps, you can only have six people, and they had the plexiglass, so you were stepping into like a almost like a phone booth type of situation. They had little window slits where you can put the cards or the money.
Now that was at New York, though, because we saw video. There's been video circulating around the internet of the Cosmopolitan.
I stay there all the time.
And it was not like that.
That might be different. This was MGM Properties.
Really?
All MGM
Properties.
Yeah, it
wasn't like that at all. Nobody was wearing masks. There were no dividers. The staff was wearing masks, but not any of the guests. Definitely not 6 feet apart.
Well, you know what I was more fearful of? I wasn't fearful of coronavirus. I was fearful of lung cancer. Everybody's smoking. Holy smack. They came out there and some of the retirees, and they lit, they had their like stack of smokes, you know, and they're just going at it. But so that was still there. But yeah, I mean, we're, the MGM properties, because we went across the MGM Grand, it was the same way. You know, it was just all very plexiglass everywhere. They had hand sanitizer. They had hand washing stations where you can actually go and wash your hands like right there. And like I said, so it was like one of the safest.
You know what else is fun to do in Vegas is to take a helicopter. And we took a helicopter on our 20th anniversary, I think, and flew to the Grand Canyon. And they take you down into the Grand Canyon. You get out of the helicopter, have a little picnic lunch with champagne, and then you fly back into – and the Vegas, the buildings, when you fly back into Vegas, they look like a Monopoly board.
Oh, my God. That's so funny.
It was – yeah, it was very – very. That was a lot of fun.
I want to do that. That, that would be one thing that I guess I would like to do. That would be fun.
So if you're looking for a short trip.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, a short weekend getaway.
Yeah.
And
I just want to, is there like a place we can go like off Earth? So we could just like, can we go to Mars?
Actually, you say off Earth. I just saw this on, you talk about the news last week, staying off the news, but someone actually for 150 grand, they will take you in this kind of what would be described as a hot air balloon. And they will lift you up into space for a couple of hours. So you're actually like orbiting the Earth or something. And then they splash you into the ocean. The boat comes pick you up.
Wow. No, I've not. I've been in a hot air balloon.
But apparently this is either a, going to be a soon reality.
Wow.
Or it is now a reality.
I
because
think I
they
just got some anxiety just thinking about.
Yeah,
it's like
not,
this big, like, imagine
is it
like.
Safe?
I don't know.
I'm sure it will be.
$150,000?
I'm sure it will be to take
you.
You
like
think it would be more expensive, though, right?
$150,000, $250,000, something like that, yeah. But it was.
Wow. I'll look that up.
But yeah, you should look it up. But but that might be something.
So what other places would we go to? God, Fiji, Maldives.
Have you been, either one of you, been to another country?
Mm-hmm. I've been to Iceland.
Iceland? How was that?
Iceland was amazing. I was there for like 20 days or something. I couldn't wait to get back home, though. But I'm always like that. Like last year, I went to Armenia. The year before, I went to Iceland. And very, very different. But Iceland was one of the most beautiful places I've ever been to in my entire life. And I went in the winter.
Wow.
So
it was freezing.
It was so cold. And they only have 4 hours of light, of daylight. And the rest of it is dark.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So it was just, it's just a different world. It's just very different. I had... Oh, God, PETA people are going to attack me. But I had whale for the first time. And I was like, what am I eating exactly? And the waiter's like, whale.
How was it?
It's like, what, oh.
You did it, yeah.
Was it tasty?
About that big. It was the most amazing thing I've ever had.
Really?
Wow. It was very weird. Yeah, wow. I didn't. And I'm very, like, I love animals. But, you know, that's what they eat there. Like, you have to kind of, and this is, like, one of the things where you go to another country, you kind of, you know, acculturate and you kind of get into their culture. I wanted to know, what do you guys eat? What do you drink? What do you like? Like, it's important without, like, putting my judgment aside. It was really, really important. But I had whale and I had some other stuff. I can't remember what it was, but.
Reindeer? Definitely... I don't know. A reindeer?
I don't know what it was, but it was an animal that I wouldn't necessarily eat. But the whale was, like, this big and they cut it up.
Like
and it
a
was
steak?
Like, yeah, it was just weird. It was like this, and it was red inside, but it's kind of looked like seared tuna.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then they just like cut it, and it was like butter.
Really?
They would cut it. Oh, it was so good.
Wow.
But yeah, it was just amazing, and the icebergs and the waterfalls and just things that you only see in pictures, you know. And so we went there, and it was the most amazing thing I've ever seen in my life. And I was so exhausted because your sleep pattern's all off. So every time
terrible,
I open my eyes, I fall asleep in the bus and I would open my eyes and I'm like, oh, and I fall back asleep again. I would open my eyes. Oh, I was very delusional. So I'm hoping half the things I thought I saw, I actually saw. But it definitely, you know, it's just an experience that you have. And I feel like now it's probably like majority of the year we haven't had those experiences. So just dreaming of going places, making plans. I know that a lot of like flights and stuff are pretty cheap right now. Like
they are.
You can go to like Bali for like
they are
a couple hundred dollars.
Really?
Yeah. There's a lot of cheap flights.
It's pretty crazy.
And even the hotels, like when I was booking the hotel in New York, it was super just like totally. Half the price that it normally is.
Yeah. Did you hang out with Bjork?
Well, I didn't go to
I didn't.
She's pretty mean. I've seen videos of her. She's a little out there. But no, it was just a beautiful, beautiful place to go. And then Armenia was just last year we went with the family and it was my first time there. I was born there. Came here when I was two, but going back is just so different. It's so calm. Yeah.
That's what I've heard.
It's so calm. Like it's, when you go to a coffee shop, you're there for like 5 hours.
Mm, wow.
They bring you fruit. They bring you coffee. Wow. Then they bring you coffee again. Then they bring you fruit. You just sit. It's not packed. It's just a different world. At 12 o'clock at night, families are outside walking, shopping, going, everything is open to like God knows when. And it's so safe. As a woman, you could just go out. Like, you could let your kids go out and play outside in the middle of the night. Like, nobody, there is nothing, like,
wow.
It's just, I was like, oh, my God, the kids are, like, outside forever. And they're like, yeah, they're always playing outside. They're fine. I'm like, aren't you afraid that someone's going to steal them? Or, like, no. And just seeing, you know, and I was so proud going there because I was like, oh, this is my, like, this is where I was born, you know?
Right.
But it's just such a different world. And if I didn't have those experiences, I don't know what I would have done. And so now just kind of being cooped up. You know, I reminisce about those experiences and I realize, wow, the interaction with people and everything is so important. And I just can't wait to go back out again and appreciate my life instead of working constantly.
Yeah.
Because I was working when I was there. I was looking at the cameras here at Hillside. Oh. Like, is everybody doing everything? And
yeah.
But I put it away and it was just so amazing. And right now, I know there's little places we can go to, but I mean, you can always get an Airbnb and like, Palm Springs or, you know, something like that and just kind of lay by the pool and do things you want to do, you know, if you can't travel or if you're scared to travel. So.
And there's bed and breakfasts all over LA even, or just even going, like you said, even just an Airbnb someplace. And that's the thing too, because just sitting here listening to your experience and reminiscing mine, you kind of get excited about life again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you kind of get like, oh wait, there's other things out there.
Yeah,
there's other things out there, and I want to go see this. I want to go do that, and it kind of gets those juices flowing again about there's more to life than just what we're dealing with right now.
Yes,
and it's easy to focus on the now, and it's important, but we also have to, if we don't get out of this, you know, mire that we're in, then, you know, we're just going to be stuck in quicksand the whole time. We're just going to continue to sink. But for me, like the lifeline is getting out and going someplace else. Cause it just, when you come back, especially you mentioned, somebody mentioned like being gone for a week, me being gone for a week, it changes everything because you come back and it's like, oh yeah, enough time had gone by that I'm out of my rut.
Mm-hmm.
I'm out of my routine of sleep until 2 p.m. because I have no place to go. I'm out of staying up till 3, 4 a.m. because, you know, I'm just binge watching Laugh Olympics, you know, whatever. So it gets you out of those routines or it gets you off of watching the news and off of social media and it refreshes you. Yeah. And so, like you said, we might be talking about exotic locales, but just something as simple as like going to Ventura and hanging on the beach for an afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
You know, going down to Orange County, you know, Balboa Island, you know, just a day trip, you know. Yeah.
I think we just get so myopic, you know, when we're not going anywhere and we're just staying by ourselves, our world just, you know, shrinks and shrinks and shrinks. So it's good to get something back on the calendar to plan for.
Yes.
Plan to, you know, we haven't been world travelers. I've only been to London and Uganda, but, and where else was I? I think that's it. Bahamas, but that's not really. It doesn't really count.
It's Bahamas would be
far
cool.
Over there. Yeah. We like. When was I there? My 19th birthday. We went on a cruise, but just to have something back on the calendar, and just I would love to travel. I would love to go to Paris and Italy and you know Spain and all these different countries. I would love to go and explore. I think that would be.
How about this? You mentioned, you know, visiting family for the first time in 3-4 weeks and how exhilarating that was. What about just going out to a restaurant? Like we had Seal Beach, for example, had opened. And so went down to Seal Beach and just ate at a restaurant. And that was it. It was like a Mexican restaurant and got some food and just kind of hung out there and had dinner. And it was just getting out to a place as simple as that. And that just was a game changer for the rest, you know, for the week that followed because you got out and just something as simple as eating in a restaurant.
Yeah, I did that too. My Yeah, we have, there's many like Armenian restaurants are like, when can we open? We're opening. Like they didn't even question it. So no, I've been to a few restaurants. It's been nice. I missed it. I just miss sitting outside and like you said, like raising my hand and someone comes to me and brings me tea, you know, or like something. It's just, it's nice. And we have to always remember that just because our environment is changing, you know, it doesn't mean that we have to get stuck in our head and let fear like take over and forget that this is temporary. Mm-hmm. Like all of this that's happening is temporary.
Temporary, yeah.
You know, the coronavirus or staying home, loss of jobs, we'll get our jobs back. I know it'll take a little bit of time, you know. It just depends on where you were working. I've never stopped working. Sometimes I wish like I could lower my hours right now. So people actually have the other problem too, where with therapists, where not really allowed to be people right now. We have to be there for other people. And so you were asking me, you know, you said, do you go to your own therapy? Yeah, I have my own therapist. I go to him. He hears all my jumbo wumbo. But just thinking, reminding yourself, this is temporary and this too shall pass. And just knowing like you can still plan things. You can still look forward to things. You can still dream. You can still make your vision board or whatever it is. And know that we'll go out and do things. So now, whatever you can do with the now, just do that. You know, don't get too stuck in the head thinking, oh my God, this feels like forever. And we're going to be, I mean, since March, right? So May, June.
It's been April. Wow, I just totally skipped over May. I take my life back in May because May didn't count. So April, May, June. It's only been like 3 months and we feel like it's been so long, right?
But look at the reality. Like a long time. It's been three months.
3 months.
Yeah.
So look at how much we've gone through in 3 months. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Like there's so much change that's happening. Yeah. But it doesn't mean that it needs to like change our entire life. We'll go back to it.
Yeah.
You know, sorry, I don't know what that
was. And then we've got hopefully some holiday festivities dentist. Coming up too, like, you know, that people might be able to do. I mean, you'd look forward to, you know, I know we kind of missed the Memorial Day weekend. You got Labor Day weekend, 4th of July, other things coming up. So, you know, maybe some of those things, if we get back to celebrating something. I know the big complaint right now is all the fireworks. Everyone's launching off at 3 a.m, you know, because that's all I see. And but again, people are wanting to do something that's a little bit more normal and what they used to do. And they just kind of overdoing it like we do because that's all people complain about is the fireworks now going off. And I was coming home from.
There's
a lot
of them. By our house too, there's a lot of fireworks going off.
I was coming up the 110 from Dockweiler Beach the other day. It was at night. And the sky lit up all over kind of south central LA. There's fireworks everywhere. It's like I was almost tempted to stop on the freeway and get out and start watching them because they were just going off. But again, people are doing something that they enjoy that is, you know, getting them out of the house, doing something fun. Yeah, a release. And, you know, so, okay, so you have to spend a couple months with less sleep. I'm sure we'll be okay. But just to go out and enjoy it too. You know, you might, you know, sure, it might be 3 a.m. and that's ill advised, but maybe, like you said, in this case, maybe go out and enjoy it because we're in different times.
Yeah. I mean, let's look at the things that we can actually do without even needing to travel maybe too far. The beach. We can go to shopping now. You know, we can – there's like little restrictions, but we can do those things. And then, you know, it's just nice to know we can go out and do things now, you know. So I love Manhattan Beach. I went to Manhattan Beach like a month ago or something like that. And it was just so nice. It was so clean. There was barely anyone on the beach. You know, I'm kind of liking this quarantine thing. I don't like to be around too many people. So I'm just like, oh, this is great. Everybody looks at me like you're a horrible person for going to the beach. And I'm like, thank you for not going to the beach. Because I can and nobody cares.
You stay home.
Stay home.
The COVID pandemic is not
horrible.
Over.
Yes. Horrible.
Stay home because we like the freeways and we like to get out and go to places we can't normally go to in the old way of life.
But I have to tell you, though, the beach is one of the most healing places you can go.
We were there yesterday. It was really nice.
The sand, like take your shoes off, dip, you know, put your feet in the sand, like lay down, go put your feet in the water, you know, breathe the air. It's such an important place to go to. And so when it was closed, I was just very upset. I was like, that's one of the places that we can go to. And I mean, who sits like this? You know what I mean? So I didn't understand it. I just had my own point of view of it. But go to the beach, go sit down, put your feet in sand and stuff like that if you can't travel. But traveling definitely is going to happen again. They're already opening things up, so it's wonderful.
And see, one of the things that I kind of was fortunate to stumble across was there was a park near Dodger Stadium here in Los Angeles that was open. It was literally open. Sign, like they had like signs up that this park is open for activities, you know, jogging, running, whatever. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot of places were closed down, even other parks, like you mentioned, the beach being closed. And so I took full advantage of that by just being able to go out there, lie in the grass or put a blanket down, listen to music or whatever the case may be, but just getting out of the house. So I think for me, when I look back on things, outside of not working, because I didn't have a job anymore, but outside of not working, I was able to kind of continue doing things that I wanted to do, the podcast, getting out, just even driving around, enjoying the open freeways, you know, things like that helped me kind of get through this a lot easier because I didn't let it impact me and weigh me down with being stuck inside, you know, watching TikTok videos and being bored in the house.
Are you on TikTok?
I do have one, but I use it for... not the way normal people use it for.
You don't do the dances?
No, I don't do the dances. I promote other things. I put my beer stuff on there, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I do that type of thing. I promote the podcast and stuff.
I had TikTok for a day.
Well, I
don't get it. I just got off of it. Yeah.
Well, see, that's the first thing that came to my mind when you said sometimes you would go in the afternoon and watch the news. Uh-huh. I was thinking, dude, you should be doing TikTok videos from your office.
Oh, God, I don't have time for that.
I'm doing TikTok videos. I'm bored in the office.
No, I'm never bored. I don't have boring moments. You know? It's like there's always some. You guys were setting up here. I did so much work at the front desk. Like there's like no. I wish I can get bored. Like I'm dreaming for the day where I'm actually bored out of my mind, and I'm just like, what can I do? You know. So maybe when that day comes, you'll know because I'll be on TikTok.
I can see you doing TikTok videos of you like talking to yourself. Yeah. You know, stuff like that.
Oh, I should do a therapy session with myself. Yes. You know, and just like switch seats. Yep.
That would be good.
Stuff like that.
That would be good.
But and I know that kind of phase kind of went because I know a lot of people on there that used to be heavy on there aren't there anymore. So I'm sure they got bored with that.
I think they said China was stealing our information. That's why.
Oh, is that what it is?
Not to get too political, but
okay.
On TikTok,
yeah. Apparently, they were saying like a lot of people stop using it because it's a app made in China.
Oh, really? Oh,
and
maybe
they
that's
were
why
stealing
they...
people's information and facial recognition.
Oh my gosh!
All these different things. So people started going off TikTok.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
well, I could explain it then. I thought people were just getting bored, but who knew?
Yeah,
I thought they were getting tired of it because they'd put.
I mean, how many dance?
How many exactly. dances can you do?
I know.
Yeah, everyone's sinks. Doing the same yep. dance.
Yep. Or the swipe where you wipe. I don't know if you've seen that one. There's one on there where you wipe the mirror and you're kind of dressed down and. Ugly-ish, and then you swipe ones on the mirror because you clean the mirror in the bathroom. Uh-huh. So you're dressed kind of, you know, down and unpleasant, so to speak. And then you wipe the mirror. And then one of the wipes, there's a flash of you all glammed out. And then the person wiping is like, wait, what? That was me? You know, so many things.
Son knows more things than
he
does.
Okay. Yeah, yeah.
I'm in the know.
You are.
It's in the social media
know. I'm on top of things. Pop culture.
You're up with the gram culture.
Yes, I am up with the gram. I'm a like I said, we're two steps ahead, but in reality, I'm also two steps behind because I'm bringing the people with us.
Yeah.
Getting them out there. So it's just been kind of fascinating though, and I would imagine you probably dealt with a lot, but it's just kind of been a fascinating when we look, take ourselves out. You mentioned a lot of times, Tara, about, the macro vision of things. You know, we look at micro vision and so we're looking at the macro vision, which is, you know, a bigger perspective, like from 10,000 feet up. And when we look at it, from a macro perspective, it's probably not as bad as we think it is. And like we've been talking about last week and this week, if we do some of the things, and I want to get back to the 3 G's again, just to give somebody, you know, something meaty that they can hang on to as we, wrap up. But if we look at it from the macro perspective, things aren't as bad. Hopefully us talking about traveling and getting out there excites you to want to go do something. And then that gets our focus off of the negative and maybe puts our energy into something more positive that we can enjoy out of life as opposed to just the negative, negative, negative.
Yeah. Or like people are hopeless, you know, it's never going to end. When is this going to end? What's going to happen? Remember, it's only been 3 months and things will go back to a normal that is your own normal. Everybody will still have a different normal. Mm-hmm. We'll be able to do all the fun things we're able to. We're still able
I to think, know. Yeah, and I think it's important to plan. I think it's important to put things on the calendar or to start new things because even though it's only been 3 months, there are still things that are still being taken off the calendar. Right. So baseball is a good possibility. It's trying to be on the calendar, but then it's off the calendar and it's on, then it's off. Right. The football season is coming up. That might be off the calendar. We don't know yet. College sports, professional sports. I mean, we're trying to, you know, move forward, but then things just keep getting taken off the calendar. So it's hard to, you know, that depression comes quickly. It comes easily, you know, because we would like for this to be over, but then things are still being taken away. So I think it's really important, I would think, for us, you know, personally to plan things, you know, plan a trip or to put something on the calendar that we can look forward to, that we have a little bit of control over, you know, start new things, start a new project right now, something that plants the seeds for life later. So that we're not just sitting here like, oh my gosh, I can't do this, I can't do that. What can we do? You know, you're talking about gratitude before. I'm always a big believer in being grateful and the opposite. So being grateful for the lessons, being grateful for the things that are still here, grateful that we can still create, we can still innovate, we can still exercise, we can still plan. There still is a calendar. The calendar hasn't been taken away. So we can still put things on it that are smaller, you know, that are in our control. That we can use to kind of have a sense of moving forward, even though we're in this, you know, era of uncertainty and the unknown. And yeah,
here's one thing people can do that I liked.
Yes.
The drive-in movie theater.
I love the drive-in movie theater. The drive-in movie
was a lifesaver. There was one in Ontario. It was Mission Tiki. I found out that it was open during quarantine and I would like go not every week, but a couple times. It was awesome.
Every week.
but it got you out of the house. It kept you safe. Oh. And
it was automatically set up for a lockdown or a quarantine. Like they were like going out of business. And now all of a sudden there's a huge purpose for them because
I'm so happy for
you're
them.
In your car and you're not next to people and you get to watch a movie. Do you hang
it's
box
all,
on the side of your window? Or
no, that's the only drawback. The cars aren't equipped because you have to have your FM
radio
on.
Yeah,
so I just have to run my car the whole time because otherwise my battery dies, it says. But no, there's one in Ontario-ish, Mission Tiki. There's one in the City of Industry, Vineland. And there's one in Paramount somewhere. And I think it's the Paramount drive-in. But anyways, that's a good place if you want to just go do something and be safe and get out of the house. Mm-hmm. And they're starting to come back with a lot of reruns. Like of old movies. They're not like new releases. Some have new releases, but they're playing a lot of old classics now.
Oh, that's
like, you
so
know,
fun.
Different type of movies. So check, you know, the computer.
I'm going to look into that. Yeah. I've never been to a drive thru.
They're so fun.
And then like we would, beforehand, we'd get there a little bit early and then we'd like play the cornhole and the toss and whatever. And we just
from your car?
Yeah. We tailgate. So we tailgate before the movie.
Yeah, it's so fun.
Are you serious?
Drive-in movies are so fun. Yeah, you bring a cooler.
I can't believe I haven't done that.
Yeah, you bring your cooler, your food, everything.
This is what happens when you go to grad school. You just live in a cave, and then people are like, drive through. You're like, is that a new thing? And they're like, no, it's been around since the 50s, I think.
It's been around since the 50s, since Greece.
Yeah.
In fact, I think Greece is coming to a drive-in.
Is it?
I think so.
I would love to see it.
But that's something
all the fun things we can do.
Just locally and be safe.
But I guess one of the things is also to point out, please don't drive with masks on.
Yes.
It's dangerous. I've had patients actually pass out in the car.
Gosh. Yep.
So, you know, drive places, go places. I mean, you can do what you want, but it's actually really dangerous to drive in the car with your mask on. Like, allow yourself to
breathe. You're not getting enough oxygen.
Yeah. People have passed out and ended up in the hospital. And
Oh, gosh.
It's been very scary. So
have common sense, people. Hillside, well, that's why I think it is.
Yeah.
Hillside Wellness Center is where we've been the last 2 weeks. We appreciate Dr. Irene for hosting us and for putting up with us and tolerating us. You can check them out online at hillsidewellnesscenter.org. And the Instagram is?
At @hillside_wellness.
And you can check them out and get little, sometimes they post some inspirational quotes and stuff. It's really good. Two Steps Ahead Podcast, @2stepsaheadpodcast is our Instagram. You can click the link in the bio. It takes you to some options, SoundCloud, Spotify, YouTube, and then also the swag shop where you can get a lot of merchandise. My personal Instagram is @EdemRocks, EidemRocks. Tara?
And I am @TaraHokeShiro, TaraHokeShiro.
And also if you go to TaraShiro.com, you can get a lot of stuff too, right, on your website?
Swag. There's a lot of swag there. You can go to the store, wear your character. And also there's a whole podcast library there as well if you want to check us out.
And one more thing, just a reminder for the community, therapy is still $25 at Hillside. So if you need help, we're here to help you. All groups are free until July and then $20 after that. So we're here to help. We want to make sure you're not stressed out about getting therapy. We have awesome therapists waiting to guide you and help you through this time especially. So,
and it's Mm-hmm. Hillsidewellnesscenter.org.
Yeah. And you guys can also, they can also call 424-261-9444. I try to get an easy number. Call us, email us, direct messages on Instagram. We have a Twitter. Any way possible. Once you put Hillside Wellness, it'll come up in Google.
Let yourself be great. Take your passion. Make it happen. Be kind.
And don't be an a-hole.
We'll see you next time.